In this video, we'll look at how to add three separate fractions, and these are fractions with different denominators. If the denominators were the same, we just add the top and bring the denominator across. But when they're different, we have to find a common factor. So there are two main ways to do this. The first way, this is a good way to do it, you could add 1/2 plus 1/3. If you add 1/2 plus 1/3, you'll end up with 5/6. Then you add the 5/6 to the 1/4 here, and then you can figure out this answer up here. If you need help with that, there are links at the end of this video, how to add 1/2 and 1/3 to get 5/6, and then there's a video on how to add 5/6 to 1/4 to get your final answer. But let's do it the second way in this video. We're going to try to find a common denominator. What we're trying to do is find equivalent fractions for each one of these where they have the same denominator. So I'm going to list multiples of 2, then 3, and then a 4, see if we can then find a common denominator. So these are the multiples here for each number. And if we look, the number that's common between these sets of multiples, the lowest number that's common, that turns out to be 12. So 12's the common denominator. We want to get each of these to be 12. So what I can do, I can multiply each of these by 1. That won't change the number. But I'm going to multiply this one by 6 over 6. 6 over 6, that gives me 12. That's going to be our common denominator. The thing is, 6 over 6 is multiplying by 1. 6 divided by 6 is 1. So we haven't changed the value. It's still going to be 0.5 for 1/2 or for 6 twelfths. Just now we have that common denominator. 6 times 1, that's 6. 6 times 2 is 12. So we have 12 as our denominator. Here I want to get this to 12, so I need to multiply by 4. But I have to multiply the top by 4 so I don't change the value. 4 times 1 is 4. 4 times 3 is 12. So now we have 12 as our denominators. Finally here, I'm going to multiply by 3 over 3. 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 4 is 12. And now we can just add these up. 6 plus 4, that's 10. Plus 1 is 13. We end up with 13 twelfths. And we could write this as a mixed fraction. 12 goes into 13 one time with 1 left over. So our answer here, adding these three fractions, 1/2 plus 1/3 plus 1/4, we get 13 twelfths or 1 and 1/12. These are the same number here. So that's how you add three fractions or more than three fractions if you want. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.